these different people. I represent the website and Youth for Crystal. I haven't quite built it yet, but I'm building my testimony so that you might be able to see what the site purpose is. Well, Youth for Crystal is a site that I'm making for the youth and for those that are in Christ, that are young, that have no place to hang out, or just get tired of hanging out with older people all the time, just want to hang out with each other and encourage one another in the Lord. But right now, I'm just working on it. I'm working on it slowly as Lord helps me and guides me and leads me through it. My name is Jeffrey Pete. I'm 22 years old, getting ready to turn 23 and 19. I've been living in Corpus Christi for a couple months now, and before this, San Antonio, Texas. Mama Jackie and Bishop had sent me here because I had gotten in some trouble with my wordings in my mouth and how I had said something through my anger and frustration the other day, how it had came out and hurt. And in coming here, I was bitter toward the members, and I finally forgave them and asked them to forgive me because they were never wrong, only I was in the situation. And so pretty much now I'm just coming to you to share my testimony. This is just the first video. It's an amateur one, as you can see, and I'm going to learn, I'm going to grow through my speech and my talking, how I'm presenting myself in the air. So just bear with me through these videos, because I'm learning, I'm growing. I'm going to start posting them more often about just random stuff, just thoughts. Just food for thought. Just food for thought, all right? And so, well, this is my testimony for somebody who bore with me so far and is here. Maybe this might help you. Before the age of 5, I was living with my real parents, and they were always angry, fighting at each other, throwing plates at each other. Me and my sister would be crying in the room. I was feeding my 3-year-old sister at the age of 5, living in parks at the age of 5, and then the state finally stepped in and said, you can't treat the children like this. And so they took us to the foster homes. And I didn't like that. Really, for the longest time, I had bitterness towards them and my parents and everything. Living in the foster homes, hate the people, going to orphanage, hating the people, living life crazy, in any worst type of way. Hate myself, hating them, and just hating everybody. Well, at the age of 10, Robert Peake and Edna Peake adopted my mom and dad. And I think before, at the time, they never really known it, because I never really showed it, because I treated them the same way I treated everybody else, through bitterness and through hate, and just didn't love them or anything. Well, and they bore with me through all the time that I was living with them. They helped me graduate school. I'm at the Simmons Career Center. Ended up finishing there, and ended up graduating in 2008. Was supposed to graduate at the summer, but they allowed me to go in the December so that I could go to the Job Corps. And then going in the Job Corps, I finally was able to serve and get my hands on things. But I was smoking drugs, doing weed, popping pills, drinking here and there. And so I got in debt to the wrong people, and I needed a way to pay them back. And so one night, me and some brothers were planning how to rob the soda machines on the property and get around the campus. So we did it. And so through the midst of this and through the midst of that, people want their money over here, want their money over there, it came out that we robbed them. And so we ended up getting put out by the grace of God. We didn't go to federal jail or anything. And so we lived off and on the streets for almost a year. Ended up staying with people that were on meth, ended up staying with people that were on crack, ended up staying with potheads, homosexuals, all kind of messed up people, hopping on freight trains and everything. And then finally, I ended up getting this job, let's put it this way, just getting a job. And my bosses, they were really encouraging me. They fell in love with me instantly, and they helped me get back on my feet, they said, and they encouraged me to go in the army. So because they helped me so much, and because I wanted to please somebody for once to get my life right, I went into the military. And then going into the military, well, I still had all that stuff in me, no way to get out, no way and everything. So I ended up going off on my drill sergeant, the other recruits and everything. And so they put me out. And they pulled me out. The AKA pulled me out and gone. Not, can't be there no more. And so, well, ended up going home for Christmas. And I'm leaving in the middle of the night. Just living on the streets again, hopping on freight trains and everything. And then finally, I just got arrested twice. Ended up going to this facility. My probation officer sent me to it. And just didn't feel right. I finally came to my end of myself. After I ended up fibbing and dabbing and worshiping the devil, I ended up ripping up Bibles, spitting on Bibles, and doing everything. But then one day, that very Bible that I was spitting on, I had to kneel down and look up to a true living God and say, God, save me. I need help. I'm going to be dead by the age of 21 if you don't come and get me out of this mess that I'm in. And so God came and reached down and got me out. He sent two people to me. One night he sent somebody to me and told me to go do this and do this, and I end up here. I didn't do what they said. I didn't trust me. And so the next morning, someone else came to me and said the same thing. So So there might be something that's going to do it. And in the process of that, by God's divine providence, I ran into this young brother, and he ended up leading me to victory of God. In 2009, in June 2009, on the 24th, I ended up getting saved. I was getting saved truly, giving my life to the Lord. And I was serving God in the ministry, and continuing to serve God in the ministry. That where I'm at is still in the ministry, serving God. My purpose and my goal is to go to Tampa, Florida, and to take Tampa, Florida, take Plant City, take Lithia, take Pinecrest, take Turkey Creek, take Dover, take Brandon, take it all in the name of Jesus, to glorify Him and to get tons of people saved. And my goal and purpose in this life is to have a team ministry and have a church over there. Will y'all pray for me and I pray for you? And I give all honor and praise to Bishop Don Banks and Mom Jackie, to my parents, and to those that help me in my walk, and I continue to help me in my walk on a daily basis, and to those of my friends that I just contacted just recently, for continuing to encourage me and help me go forward in Jesus' name. So I just give you all honor and all glory, Lord Jesus, my friend. Amen.